Today we're going to walk you through how to set up the AutoBox 2L and the initial operation and checkout of the machine. The first thing you'll have to know is what type of heat exchanger you have. This particular one we have is fairly small and doesn't have any bolt holes in the flange. If you did happen to have a heat exchanger with a bolt pattern, you could utilize this type of clamp attachment where you would pick up the center bolt hole on the top and bottom of the heat exchanger and then the second or third bolt out. And that'll kind of just help get it lined up. And it's just a little simpler of an installation. Since we have the version with no bolts, we'll be using the standard clamps to attach those. And it'll require two top clamps for the top rail and two clamps for the bottom rail. These are pretty simple to set up. There is a jam nut back here that you want to use to set the approximate width of your flange. So when you tighten the clamp mechanism, it gets good contact on both surfaces of the flange face. When you're setting these up, you want to install them so that they're symmetric. It'll just make getting the top rail level easier down the road. The bottom clamps are essentially identical to the top clamps. The only difference is the static part of the clamp is on the bottom as it is on the bottom on the top. Okay, now I'm going to install the rails. The top rail will be a slotted rail and the slots will face towards the machine. These just kind of sit on the bottom top clamps and then you kind of just rotate them in place. Before you tighten them down completely, just get them good and snug and then we'll level that top rail. And you just want to be sure this rail is level with the tubes in the tube sheet. And once you get those where you want them, you can go ahead and tighten everything down securely. The bottom rail installs the same way. It'll be a non-slotted rail. And this rail doesn't necessarily need to be perfectly level to the top, but it's always a good idea to get it as close as you can. And then you can go ahead and secure it fully. Okay, now that we have the rails on, we'll start by sliding the horizontal carriage on. This carriage has a lever that you can use to release the gear and engage it in the rail. So as you can see here, it's free to move, and as you engage it, it locks the gear into the slotted rail. This is just an idler carriage for the bottom of the rail, and it goes on here. And then you can put your vertical rail in. You'll want the slotted rails facing out on that one as well. As you're bringing this down, you'll want to engage these two rollers and leave about a foot above the clamp here. This is the clamp that secures the vertical rail to the top horizontal rail. Now we can install the vertical rail, or the vertical carriage, I'm sorry. It has a similar mechanism to engage the gear in the rail. So in this position, this rail is engaged, but the horizontal rail is not, so it will still slide freely back and forth. And that essentially completes the frame setup. Okay, so here's the AutoBox 200 or 2L, and this is basically the tractor portion of the drive, and this here is the front guide assembly that attaches to the front of the AutoBox and then also interfaces with the positioner. I'm just going to run through a couple functions really quick. This top hex is for tightening down on the tubes once you get your pitch selected. And this here is what adjusts your pitch. So with the clamp loose, as you turn this, you can see that it's tightening the pitch, and it can achieve whatever the diameter of the guide tubes is. These are the larger guide tubes, and they're half inch pipe or 0.84 inch OD. And then it'll adjust out to approximately 2.5 inches with this size of guide tubes. Once you get them set where you want them, you just tighten the clamp down and that'll hold their position. For now, I'll just set them right there and we'll actually set the pitch on the heat exchanger. The second part of the guide assembly is a hose stop assembly, an anti-withdrawal device. It works by having two plates. So it's shown now in the open position. And as you tighten this screw down, there's actually two hardened stainless steel plates that close and catch the crimp of the hose. And the nice feature about this is you don't need a lot of collets. It basically can be set for any hose size between 3.2 and 6.4. And we'll go through the proper setup of that in just a moment. The actual tractor assembly has two doors on the front side of the unit. It just shows the rollers. So the AutoBox comes with two rollers, a grooved version and a smooth version. The roller with the grooves is suitable for hoses 5.4 or larger OD up to 6.4. And then the smooth groove rollers are suitable for hose sizes less than 5.4 down to 3.2 hose. Today we're going to be running 5.4 hose with BN13s, and so we've installed the rollers with the groove. So if you have to replace any rollers while the machine's on the frame, you just want to make sure that the keyway's facing up before you disengage the detent. So you can see here there's just a detent ball, and that's basically what holds the roller on. And so before I pull this roller off, I want to rotate that detent ball vertical down, which means the keyway's up on top. And then you can use a screwdriver or another flat tool to just disengage that ball. You can kind of see that motion there. And you just want to hold it up while you pull the roller off. So this is the inside, or the back surface. It'll face the inside of the machine. The round part is for the roller detent, and then the square section is for the keyway. So as you reinstall the roller, you just need to make sure that the detent is facing down, the key is facing up, and you install it to where it starts on the detent, and then you just simply push it on till it clicks. Okay, so now we're ready to install our hoses. It's probably simplest to go ahead and install this front guide assembly on the machine. So the two pins basically secure it. And we don't have any hair hooked up now, so it's the rollers are in the open position. If you happen to be operating it and had clamp on the tool, you would want to release that clamp pressure to fully open the rollers before trying to install the hose. And the hose installation is fairly simple. Just stick the hoses in the front tubes and then just push them through the machine, push them through the front guide until they're actually outside the front of the machine. And once they're outside the guide, you can reattach the Banshee tools, and then we'll be ready to go mount it on the positioner. So today we're using BN13s, so we'll just install them on the ends of the hose. Should always use anti-seize on those threads, and always use the appropriate wrenches. So once your hoses are in, we want to be sure that the hose stop is actually catching on the crimp of the hose. And so the way to do that is just to tighten this down until you feel it contact the hose. And it's always good to feel the amount of contact that there is there. I would estimate that's around 5 to 10 pounds of drag. And then you just stick this pin in and then back it off until your pin goes in. And then you'll see that that frees up the hoses. And you just want to double check that that they can't back out. And they're quite stuck in there. So once you have the guide assembly attached to the drive assembly and your hoses installed and you've verified that your backout preventer is working correctly, you can now position the AutoBox assembly onto the positioner. And to position it on, you want to set the front rail in this slot, and then there's a chamfer to help you start into there. And and you want to slide it in until your guide tubes have a little bit of clearance with the tube face. If you had a channel head in this situation, you know, the tube face would be much further back in there, and you would have to run longer guide tubes. The way to measure your guide tubes is just measure from the face to the end of the channel head and add that number to the stock guide tube length, which is 11.5 inches. So with this in place and set correctly off of the tube sheet face, you can tighten these four clamp bolts. There's two on the top and two on the bottom. And those are a 9/16. And with the top carriage loose, you can now kind of align the guides to the tubes and do your final pitch setup. And once you get those where you want it, just tighten down the clamp again. Okay, so the vertical carriage, it has the clamps that connect the AutoBox guide assembly, but it also has a secondary clamp for mounting a Barracuda or Spitfire. And in the event that your heat exchanger has a channel head, we've actually made collets that'll take 9/16 lances. And that way you can get the tool back in the channel head closer to the face. Now we're ready to start installing the air control lines. We recommend taping the ends of your hoses just so you know which one it is, and always blowing out your hoses before you connect them to the machine. On the AutoBox, there's color-coded bands for each function, and those correspond to the fitting on the control box as well. So with your hoses labeled, you can just connect those right up to the machine. On the positioner drives, you want to be sure that that you always use these caps to keep dirt and moisture out of the motor. And in the event that the motor fails to rotate when you give it air, you can loosen these two bolts and pull the motor out of the gearbox and then break the motor shaft free by hand and then reinstall it. The air lines for the vertical drive are in the same bundle as the AutoBox. The air lines for the horizontal drive are in their own bundle, and they connect to this motor. So we're ready to connect these up to the control box. And as you can see, there's color coding on all these fittings as well. And then you can connect your air supply line, and that's a Chicago style connector. Okay, and then once you hook your positioner control lines up, if your left-right motion doesn't correspond with the nameplate or the engraving, all you need to do is just switch these two, and that'll correct it so that the motion actually matches the engraving on the plates. Now is when you'd want to check and make sure that the positioners move in the intended direction you want, as well as to verify that all the pneumatic features are working. We don't recommend ever operating a machine with the door down, but during the checkout, as long as nobody's around it, it's fine to just make sure that the rollers are reacting to the clamp pressure. As you can see that motion there. And also that the drive directions are correct. And the positioner drives, you can check at this time. You want to make sure that the drives are all engaged. So once you've verified that the controls are all doing the appropriate function, it's time to set the hose stops. So you would run to the end of the heat exchanger, get your stroke length you want, and then you can tighten these stops. They take a 9/64. The hose stops are engraved with the OD range that they cover. So yeah, you just slide that up. There are four cap screws, and there's some roll pins that are in there so that you can't lose the small screws. But what that requires then is that you tighten all four uniformly. And then you also want to watch the gap here and on the opposite side here to make sure that you're getting a uniform clamp and that all four screws are getting the same amount of tension. Then it's always good just to verify that those are stopping the machine. Okay, and that completes the setup of the positioner frame, the AutoBox 2L drive, and the guide assembly. Okay, so once you get your hoses ran through the machine, you'll want to connect them up to this Y manifold, and then you would want to connect your hose between the dump valve and the lances here. And the kits that we're sending out for field testing won't have a dump valve, so you'll have to supply your own. But if you run some 1/4-inch OD nylon tubing from the pneumatic operated dump port to the control box does have a dead man switch to remotely operate the dump. And so your high pressure hose, of course, you would connect to one side of the dump, and then your short jumper hose here would connect to the other side of the dump. And that would pretty much complete the setup of the AutoBox 2L field test machines.